about to do it like this, about to do it like this, y'all. When I sit back and imagine life without you, I can't fathom how I ever thought I'd make it on my own. And there's at least a million reasons I'm still standing here believing. You're my comfort, you're my healing. This I know. This I know. When you can't see the wind, when it moves the leaves, from the bottom to the top of the tallest trees, you are everything I'll ever need, and they can't take that from me.
Ready to begin. Well, welcome to chapel. Let's stand. You're going to work out today. Okay? So we're going to sing a song that's going to go like this. I want you to go like this with your legs and go like this. Before I go, 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 I stop. Go like that. Before I go, 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 I stop. Before I go, I stop. I don't want my day, I don't want my day to flop before I go, 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 I stop. Okay, you'll get some of the other ones when it comes around. Here we go. Get ready. Can you see? Come on up here.
Before I go, 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 I stop.
That's it, come on.
Before I go, go, go. Before I go, I stop. I don't want my day to flop. Before I go, 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 I stop.
Now watch this. This is where we get our way.
Before I run, run.
Nice. Okay. All right, you got a little exercise, but this next one. So we're going to do this. It's going to go like this. It's going to go step. You can do your heel. Step, back, step, back. Step, back, step, back, step, back, step, back. Now, what it's going to do is it's going to go like this. Take your fist, and we're going to go step, back, step, back. So it goes, on we go. Okay, have you heard this song? It's about some animals and going forward with God. We're going to pretend we're an elephant, and we're going to go, we are wild about God. Can you do that elephant trunk? So it goes, on we go. Woo, hoo, hoo. We are wild about God. Yes, wild about God. On we step. Woo, hoo, hoo. Elephant, we are wild about God. Yes, wild about God. Now, it's going to start another part. It says to know him. So you're going to point like this. To know him and a fist. To trust him. To take us. Take the lead. Thank you. They need to help me. Like this. And we're going to pretend we're lassoing in the joy stampede. And then it goes, on we go. Hoo, hoo, hoo. We are wild about God. Push it up there. You're wild about God. On we go. Hoo, hoo, hoo. We are elephant. Wild about God. Punch. Wild. Okay, there's some others. Now, he's going to sing a verse. We're just going to repeat after him. Okay, and some of it is just walking. Can you pretend to walk? All right, here we go. This is called On We Go, We're Wild About God. Here we go. Now we're going to do a hum like this. Can you walk it? Hum. Again. Hum.
It's a holy day.
God has a message. It's a holy day.
God has salvation for each one who prays.
God has salvation for each one who prays.
To know him, to trust him, to take the lead in the joy.
Wild about.
go sit down. Excellent. Give a hand for our worship leaders. You may go sit down. Thank you. Go ahead. Good job, everyone. Good job. Go ahead, Bianca. Back to your class. Atta girl. Okay, everyone look at your teacher. Are they huffing and puffing? I am. Okay. Great. Well, welcome to chapel. I have the privilege of speaking, so let's pray, okay? Oh, Jesus, we love you. We desire to serve you and be more like you. Sometimes, though, our hearts and our wills don't always want to be like you. Would you help us to seek you? In Jesus' name, amen. Repeat after me. This one thing. Seek the Lord. You know it. Let's say it together.
This one thing. Seek the Lord.
Awesome. Awesome. Question is, do you know where it's found in the Bible? What Bible verse is it? Oh, I gotcha. It's a big, long book in the middle of the Bible. Begins with a P. Yes, I heard it. Psalm. Yes, over here. Nicely done. Psalm 27, verse
4.
You guys rock. Psalm 27, 4. Good. You know, it's been said that the more you spend time with someone, the more you become like them. Do you think that's true? Just thumbs up, thumbs down. Maybe not so sure. Yeah. Okay. I think that's true some ways, in some ways. You have someone who laughs a lot, they'll tend to make you laugh a lot. You have somebody who's kind of grumpy all the time, you can get kind of grumpy all the time. Okay? All right. Did I do something? I did. So, as we seek the Lord and spend time reading the Bible and praying, I'm so sorry, Mr. Serb. Okay. I don't know if I did this right. As we spend time praying, reading God's word, okay, spending time with others who love Jesus, hopefully our love for Jesus will grow too. We'll become more like our friends. How do we show this, though? How do we show the love of Jesus? I'd like to share three ways that we're going to talk about. And I'm so sorry. How's that? That's better. Okay, I'm going to share three ways. Oh, thank you. I have never done well with these things. Okay, I'm going to share three ways that we are really going to look at. It's called the three B's. The three B's. The ways to show Jesus' character. And we're doing this not only in preschool, not only in lower school, but in middle school and upper school. Yep, we know about. So the B's are like this. Be respectful. Now, I'm going to go like this. This is sign language for, does anyone know? Thank you. Thank you. So be respectful. Be respectful. Say thank you, be polite, all of those. Okay? Be responsible. I'm going to go like this. Be respectful, be responsible. So people in the Army, whether they really agree with their supervisor or the sergeant or the major in charge, they don't get to question it. If he says take off your shoes, they take off their shoes. If he says walk in your bare feet in the mud, they walk in their bare feet in the mud. Because when they are in a battle in the Army, the Navy, the Air Force, the Marines, you don't have time to question. They have to do what they're told. So I'm going to go be respectful. We are going to do what we are told. So it's be responsible, be respectful, be courageous. Okay, we're going to talk about those. So the first thing is going to be respectful. In Matthew 7, chapter 12, it says, so in everything, do to others what you would have them do to you. It's kind of like the golden rule. do unto others as you would want them to do to you. So what does respectful look like? One might be showing kindness, asking someone to play, show kindness, comforting a friend. Another, oh, I like this one. Don't complain. Stop complaining. Hi, boys and girls, you're gonna have a quiz. No, you said it was gonna be tomorrow. No, I can't. I didn't study. Nope. You're going to have a quiz. You can say it in your mind, but you don't have to share it with anybody else. You can go, in your mind. Okay? Waiting to be called on. That's not fair. You didn't call on me. No, that's not fair. No, you wait. You don't complain. I'm going to be first in line. No. You're okay with second in line or fifth in line or even last in line. Don't complain. You're okay. You're all getting to the same place at the same time. Okay? This one. Can you be a good loser? Can you be a good loser? I have to tell you, for some of you, that's really, really hard. That takes a lot in us. And I want to tell you a secret. You're not always going to win. So get used to it. Okay? You are going to lose at some point, whether it's at checkers, whether it's at a sport, whether it's at a spelling bee or a race, whether it's cars going along or bikes, you're riding bikes, you don't get the bike that you always want. It's not even losing, it's just that you're not always going to get what you want. Okay, so showing respect means showing kindness, not complaining. Here's the next one, being polite. In group projects, do you allow everyone to speak? Or are you like, no, we're going to do it my way. No, my way. We're going to do it this way. I say this way. No, you have to be polite and respectful in group projects. Allow everybody to speak. Allow even the quiet person to be able to give a suggestion. Okay? Oh, my goodness. Holding the door open for someone. I am always shocked when this happens. I have to tell you, and not to point out, but wherever Matthew's song is, he always holds the door open for me. I have to say, you know what? I remember that. I remember that. And so that's a wonderful thing to show respect. Okay? Mr. Schroeder, and I'm sure Mr. Davis does too as well, where they ask the boys, wait a minute, hold the door, allow the girls to go first. Sometimes the boys get to go, but remember, you don't always win. You don't always get first. We're going to be happy. Okay? All right. How about this one? I know some of you are shy, but when your teacher, Miss Okamoto, might be Mrs. Quintero, somebody says, good morning, do you just go? Or do you just go? Being polite is actually using words. Say, good morning. You know what? You'd probably make me faint or someone else faint if you said, hi, Mrs. O, how are you? Oh, my goodness, you asked a question? Good morning, Mrs. Castle, even using her name. Oh, my. Hi, Mrs. Lott, did you have a good night? Mrs. Herman, how are you doing today? Whoa, they would probably faint, all right? Mrs. Loza, how are you doing today? To use their names, okay? Yeah, there we go. Good morning, Mrs. Lee. How are you? All right, respond when people talk to you. Don't just smile. Use words. And for some of you, that's very difficult. Not only that, look them in the eye and say, right? Isn't that a song we do? Look them in the eye and say. look them in the eye and say, right? Good morning. Okay. All right. Here's another one of showing respect. Obey the rules, whether it's in the classroom, whether it's at recess, whether it's in, oh my, the lunchroom. Mm-hmm. But this one, in the hallways or wherever, even when nobody's watching. Ah, can you do that? Can you obey? Okay, so that is be respectful. Say that. Be respectful. Be responsible. Okay, Colossians says, whatever you do, work heartily for the Lord, not as for men. What does responsibility mean? Do your best in PE, even if you're not good at something. Oh, great, we're playing badminton. Oh, we're going to run the mile. I can't even run from here to there. I'm going to do my best, okay? In the classroom, you don't feel good at spelling. You don't feel good at math. Do your best, okay? Do your best even in a job, they ask. Somebody asks you, Mrs. Lee asks, will you pick up that trash? So you pick up one and you leave 20 others. Hello, there's 19 other pieces of trash there. You can pick up all of them. And you throw them in the trash can, but they all flitter all over the place. Are they in the trash can? No. Get them in there, okay? Be responsible. The other is to serve others. So do your best, serve others. Help a classmate. Okay, this one is one that really gets me. Would you help a classmate and be kind to them and flush the toilet when you go? It's disgusting going into a bathroom when you don't flush the toilet, isn't it? I'm telling you. It's disgusting. Paper towels, get them in the trash. You're being kind and responsible, serving others. Okay? Pick up the trash when you see them. Help to clean up. Okay, another one. In being responsible, you stay organized as best as possible. Stay organized. Whether it be your desk, your locker, or even a paper you hand in. Is it all messy? Is it all crumply? Is it all dirty? Did you spill your water bottle on it? Do you have dirty hands and it's all... The teacher, should they have to take the time to really read all that? No. You've put all that work into it, you need to get credit for it. So, okay, stay organized. And the last is, when they ask you to do something and be responsible, when anybody asks you, do the job right. Because you know what they're going to ask. If you didn't do it the first time, they're going to say, go back and do it again. So now you've taken twice the amount of time. Make your bed. Hello, Johnny, Susie. They're not. Your bed's not made. Do it again. Okay? You don't need to comment, sir. Thank you for listening quietly, everybody. All right. Yeah. Okay. So, you don't want to have to do it over. Do it well. The last one is be courageous. Now, that doesn't mean, yee-haya. Yee-haya. Okay? That doesn't mean that. That means, are you willing to stand up for what is right? Are you? Are you courageous enough to do that? Or are you weak enough to join with people who don't do what's right? Those are the weaker people, okay? Stand up for what's right, even if you stand alone. Even if you stand alone. Now, I can tell you, sometimes people think you're cool if you don't do what's right. Think again. You may think you're cool. It's not. Not only is it not God-honoring, but people don't enjoy that. You think they might, but they don't. And what it shows about a person's character is that they want attention, they want all that, and that they're insecure. or they can't have self-control. Okay? So, here we go. Being courageous means, can you ask for forgiveness? Can you say, I'm sorry, even when they're still angry with you? Even when they're angry. Can we do that? That would be hard. Mr. Schroeder, I'm really sorry. I broke your water bottle. And he's still upset because it was his favorite White Sox water bottle. I feel badly, and he's still upset, but I'm still going to ask for forgiveness. Now, that takes courage because he's not always happy then with me. Even when you've hurt somebody's feelings. I'm so sorry, Mrs. Lee. I said that. I didn't mean it. I want to apologize. I really, will you forgive me? And she says, yes, but that really hurt. Ugh, okay, but I'm going to ask for forgiveness. Being courageous means, are you willing to take risks? Like being willing to stand in front of people and speaking? Some of you, that's really tough. Second grade, did whale projects in front of a camera, in front of all the parents. You have done chapels, some of you, and some of you will, and got up here when you're not comfortable being on the stage. It's awesome. For some, like my worship leaders, they don't mind being up in front of people, but for some, it's very scary. Okay? You, another one, take risks. Could you ask some people if you could play with them? Whoa. You see a group of people you want to play with. Can you say, can I play with you? That takes a lot of courage, because what might they say? And that hurts your feelings. But you have to be willing to take a risk. Now, I am going to tell you this. There should be no closed games at CHA. So if someone says, can I play with you? You should be saying yes. Unless it's like basketball with a 5-on-5. Or gaga ball. There's a limit there. But if you're running around playing tag and somebody comes up and says, can I play? I hope you say yes, because you can have as many people as you want. And you're not supposed to say no. Okay? So you have to take a risk on your own and ask to play with them. Don't always wait for others to ask you. Then the other is you stepping out and seeing a lonely friend and saying, hey, come play with us. Can you have the courage to do that? Even if people don't like that person, can you step out, see someone off by themselves, ask them to play because they're feeling lonely or unhappy? All right. The last is, so ask for forgiveness, take risks, be engaged. Be engaged. Don't just sit there with your hands folded and a smile on your face. Somebody who is like Jesus took risks. They were courageous. They did things. Somebody drops a pencil, you get out and you help them. Somebody's sad, you go and ask them, are you okay? Do you need someone to talk to? Do you want to play with me? They're sitting off by themselves with lunch. Are you okay? Would you like to join us for lunch? Okay, the other in being courageous, you see your friends bullying, you say no to bullying. Okay? You say no to bullying. All right? Now, boys and girls, I'm going to tell you. I have heard that there are some students and some older students within lower school that are doing some things in the bathrooms, like peering into the bathrooms when someone else is going to the bathroom. The little ones, if I find out who it is, I'm not happy with it. You better expect consequences. And it is not funny. I get emails from parents who say, my child's afraid. They shouldn't be afraid to come here. It'd be the same if a high schooler came to you and bullied you. That is wrong, and we won't have it. I won't put up with it. And you know what? The Lord doesn't either. Don't do it. And if you see someone else being mean, you say, stop. Pull that friend away that's being bullied and say, come on, let's move away. Or let's go tell our teacher, or let's go talk to someone. That's not tattling, you're protecting your friend. It's standing up. If you look at all the people in the Bible, they had to stand up for what was right. Speak up when someone is wrong. Okay, so here we go. These three: be respectful, be responsible, be courageous. Let's say that. Be respectful, be responsible, be courageous. Now, let's strive to do all three. What I want to say is this, boys and girls. You know, sometimes do you feel like, you know what, I behave all the time. And the people who get more attention are always the people who are yelling out or who misbehave. I don't want to celebrate that. So this is what we're going to do. Teachers, if you get a chance, I don't have time today to talk about who Daniel is in the Bible. Do you remember? He was thrown in the lion's den for not obeying the king. And Esther, who risked getting her head cut off because she went to the king to talk to him without being invited first. You're not allowed to go talk to the king without being invited. But she wanted to talk to him to save God's people. We are going to be handing out Daniel and Esther awards once a month. And it's going to be one person per class. So, for example, like Mrs. Loza and Mrs. Herman, there's two third grades. They may have one from Mrs. Herman, one from Mrs. Loza. Whether it's a boy or a girl, a boy, you'll get the Daniel Award. A girl, you'll get the Esther Award. And it is to celebrate you who are respectful, responsible, and courageous. It's to celebrate those of you who are seeking to become more like Jesus. Now, I'm going to tell you now, not everybody will get the award throughout the whole year. That's not the goal. You have to see. Can you do that, and can you do these things when nobody's looking? Or when it might be that Mrs. Lee's not there, but Miss Okamoto steps out in the hallway, and there run people down the hall. No. At lunchtime, Mr. Davis lets the fifth graders go, and I step out of my office. I about get knocked over. No. I see those who are walking. And even, heaven forbid, greet me. Hi, Miss Okamoto. And use my name? Wow. That's wonderful. It blesses me. It blesses your teachers. It blesses others. So, starting the end of November, this is November, end of November, your teachers will be giving me one name of a person who should receive the Daniel or Esther Award, and then I'm going to bring you up here, and we're going to celebrate you, okay? And each month, we're going to do that, just one person. All right, one more time. Be respectful. Oh, be respectful. Be responsible. Be courageous. Good. Those are the three B's we're going to really try to do at CHA. All right, good. Well, you know what? I heard that Gus has been around, and so take a look.
Miss Okamoto, I thank you so much for your words about being respectful and being courageous, because it gives all of us, but even me, it gives an opportunity for the love that we have for Jesus not to be hidden, but we get to live it out. We get to live it out. And one of those ways that I'm excited is Cornucopia, because beyond maybe ice cream, beyond maybe Culver's, but we get to roar for the floor in our library, that carpeting, That beautiful 70-year-old orange carpeting. Some of us, when we go to the library, we get to sit on that, but we have an opportunity to live out our faith and act and do something to show everyone the love we have for Jesus. And that's Cornucopia. So many great things that we could do this year. But I'll tell you, someone who loves Jesus just as much as me, there is a family that if we raise the goal of $100,000, there is a family that will match that $100,000, which means for every dollar that you might give, and you don't have to, but if you do, every dollar that you give, it's like giving two. So if we raise $100,000, that could be $200,000. So I am going to give some money. But you know who's really fired up about this as well? Rory is. I asked Rory if he could make it today. He could not. But I'm going to give money. I'm going to give money. Yes, I will. But you know who else is going to give money? And you know who's already raised about $1,000? The fifth graders. I'm giving money. I'll give money. Yes, I will. I'll give money. Fifth graders, how about you? I'll give money. We'll give money. Fifth graders, I'll give money. Yes, I will. I'll give money. What about you? I'll give money. Yes, I will. I'll give money. How about you? Come on, C-H-A, hey, C-H-A, hey, C-H-A, hey, C-H-A, hey. Fifth graders, come on down. Fifth graders, come on down. Let's ask our lower school friends. Come on. What a good cause, and it's an opportunity for us to live out our faith. So we're going to do all of the lower school. Looking at the time, I'm going to give all the kindergarten. What do you think? Would you be willing to? First grade? Second grade, would you be willing? Third grade, would you be willing? Fourth grade, would you be willing? All of us together. We'll give money. Yes, we will. We'll give money. What about you? We'll give money. Yes, we will. We'll give money. How about you? C-H-A, hey, C-H-A, hey, C-H-A, hey, C-H-A, hey. Who's gonna give? Yeah, come on, C-H-A, come on, C-H-A. We can do this, $100,000. Let's do it for Jesus. Amen?
Wow, fifth grade has already set it on fire. The bar is high. $1,000. Let's keep it going. Let's keep it going. All right. Now, there will be prizes, but we're going to wait just a little bit before we announce some of those prizes, okay? Here's what I want to ask you. Does anybody have a grandparent? Raise your hand. Okay. Stand up if you have two grandparents. Okay. Sit back down. Stand up if you have three grandparents. Okay, sit back down. Stand up if you have no grandparents. Okay, I gotcha. Okay, stand up if you have four grandparents. Okay, sit back down. Stand up if you have an older person that's a special friend. Come on. Okay, good, sit down. All right. Hey, coming up is Thanksgiving. And before Thanksgiving, what we usually do is we have a grandparent chapel. Now, because of COVID, rats, that COVID, I'm ready. I want to get rid of this, don't you? I'm telling you. I am so ready to be done with masks. But here we go. We're going to have a grandparent chapel, but because we can't have grandparents in here, because we really don't want them to get sick, especially since they're in the older category, is there something that they can do that's a special or a one of a kind? Like, can they go like this with their fingers? Put two on one side and put two on the other? Is that something special? Okay, it's a tough thing. Or I'll tell you a secret. Here's my special thing. You ready? Shh. Here it is. I can take a square saltine and flip it in my mouth without even touching it or ever breaking it. I guess that goes to show that I've got a big mouth, but that's my skill. So what we're asking is, your grandparents, can they climb a mountain, ride a unicycle? Maybe they've written a book. Can they make sushi? Are they an artist? Can they sing? Or do they have some kind of talent? We're going to be asking them to videotape themselves, just a wee tiny video. And then it's going to be a contest, and we're going to show the winners at the grandparent chapel of those who have the most unusual and fun talent. So you've got to talk with your grandparents. Say, hey, grandma, grandpa, whatever you call them. I can't think in there. Mimi or whatever. And say, hey, what do you do that is special? I really like your apple turnovers. Could you take a quick video of that? And send it in. Now, it can be your grandparent or it can be your special friend. They can do that too. Okay? So they're going to go online, on our online, and I think an email is going to go out, and they'll have instructions on how to do that. Okay? All right. So encourage your grandparents to make a video and send it in, and maybe you'll see your grandparent or your special friend up here, and they'll win. If I were a grandparent, I'd love to win showing you how to flip a saltine in my mouth. Okay? All right. Boys and girls, would you do me a favor and stand as I pray and close our chapel? You've been such a great audience. What a good crew. I know. Come on. And you know what? You know what I'm so sad about? I am sad that there is no school tomorrow, Friday. Wait a second. Wait a second. Okay. You are good. Let's pray and thank the Lord. Father, thank you so much that you desire for us to be respectful, to be responsible, to be courageous. That is in your word. And so would you help us to become more like that? I, Miss Okamoto, look forward to celebrating those students this year who show those character qualities. And I'm sure there are many of them. Would you help us to become more like Jesus? Father, would you also encourage us, help us to bring in coins for our school so that we might be able to change our carpet in the library? Mrs. Mack is so excited for that. And even now we've got new shelves that are coming in. She's preparing for it. But also, Father, might we encourage and honor our grandparents and special friends with the videos that they send in. And even if they don't feel that they have something special, maybe we as grandchildren can think of something we'd love to see them do, and we might give suggestions as well. Thank you so much for every penny that comes in. To you be the glory, in Jesus' name, amen. Have a seat. All right, here we go. We're going to go on with dismissal. I'm going to hold up my fingers. Mr. Serb, is it possible to put on we go? And I'm going to hold up my fingers. If I go like that, that means K. But I'm going to dismiss you as we sing this song, okay? Here we go. You ready? Let's see. Stand up, please. My worship team may come up if you'd like. Come on.
It's a holy day.
one who prays.
God has salvation for each one who prays.
To know him, to trust him, to take the lead in the joys that beat. So on we go. Ooh. We are wild about God.
Yes, wild about God.
On we go.
Ooh.
We are wild about God.
Yes, wild about God.
Yes, wild about God.
No.
Jesus, Messiah, share him with your friends. Till everyone has had the chance.
Share him till everyone has had the chance.
That's right. To know him, to trust him, to take the lead in the choice.